Hey, maybe we'll get the day off tomorrow, no practice, and I'll buy you lunch to congratulate you, okay?
What kind of lunch?
Whatever you sushi. I know you like sushi.
Yes.
Okay, deal. I'm buying Geno lunch.
Hello and welcome to another edition of Inside Penguins Hockey presented by UPMC, the official healthcare provider of the Pittsburgh Penguins. And welcome to beautiful Santa Monica, California. I'm Dan Potash. You know, scoring 400 goals in the National Hockey League, no easy task. Finding time to have lunch with Geno and his busy schedule, challenging, but doable. As it turned out, we had more than just great food. We had great conversation that went well beyond the sport of hockey.
Okay, so you made me wait a long time to take you to lunch.
It's your fault. It's not my fault. What are you talking about?
Well, 400 goals.
400 goals? 400 what? Dollars tonight? Today? My lunch?
Let's see how much you can... No, you have game tomorrow. You can't eat that much. You could try.
I bring it home to my family.
Oh, you want to go bags?
She loves sushi. She loves salmon. She loves, like, all stuff.
Okay, so let me ask you this. When was the first time... I know you love sushi. When was the first time you had sushi?
Oh, it's a nice question. Like... First time, you know, I tried like long time ago, probably I was like my hometown, like first restaurant, first sushi open, like was here. Like I was like 15 probably, or 16, like, you know, and like I don't like I try like sashimi, like salmon, unagi, you know, eel.
Yeah.
And first time, usually people like my friends, like my mom, when like you try first time, people don't like, they not understand right away, yeah. You know, it's weird test, you know, and like first time I try, maybe it's not good restaurant, you know, not great fish, you
right.
know, because like it's like small hometown, but after like I'm try like a couple times after in Moscow, you know, I feel like better like every time, and now I love it, you know, it's my favorite food.
What was the first American food that you really enjoyed?
Hot dog?
Hot dogs and mayonnaise?
And ketchup too. Oh. What?
I remember when the All-Star
it's
game.
Only one guy you like don't like mayonnaise and ketchup together. Like
that's
great sauce.
That's Russian dressing.
Yeah, best dressing.
But in a hot dog?
Sausage, yeah. No. And bread.
No.
If you ask, okay, questions for your like fans or like your people like guys like, is that like dressing like ketchup and
yeah,
mayonnaise?
On a salad, Russian dressing.
No, and hot dogs. And most guys say yes. Most guys try. Like
no. No. It's disgusting.
See it.
Oh, I hear it. Take me back to the summer when you were training in Florida.
Yeah.
You can't eat any of that, right?
No.
Because you're training. So is it hard to say no to...
My choice, you know, like... when like season is over, you know, and like I have 2 weeks and I eat all of them, you know, I like drink beers, like Coke, like pizza.
Anything.
Yeah, like couple weeks, like 10 days, you know.
Yeah.
And after like done, you know, and I'm start like a little bit like play tennis, like, you know, like swim, and like I'm stop eat like bad food. I mean like fast food.
I mean, you're a young guy now, 33?
Almost 44.
You know who you did your first interview with, right? Back at the draft in Carolina?
Who? No way. You have a picture? Well, like, you have
video? Well, I had the interview. You couldn't speak any English. You had your hair all brushed down like this in front.
I'm already like...
Came to the draft.
Yeah.
Penguins selected you. I did the
already
first interview.
Already select? Or after select or before?
Right after the... Right after,
like...
Yeah.
Stage?
Yes. And I interviewed you one-on-one through your translator.
No
Me.
Way.
I'll show you a picture.
Yeah, you
In
have
fact,
picture.
I'll autograph for you.
No way.
I can't believe you don't remember. How could you forget your first time with me?
Well, the talk yesterday was that Evgeni Malkin was going to become a Pittsburgh Penguin. Well, today it's official. You're wearing the new jersey. You are officially a Pittsburgh Penguin. How does it feel?
I still haven't completely realized the meaning of this. I was very worried, but I'm extremely happy to be picked by Pittsburgh. I know it's a beautiful city and terrific fans.
Congratulations and welcome to Pittsburgh.
Поздравляю, добро пожаловать в Питтсбург.
Спасибо.
Thank you.
Oh Wow.
Special moment.
How long? It's like 15 years ago, yeah? No, it's
2006?
More. 2006? Six, yeah.
Yeah,
2006. No, 2004. I come to Pittsburgh 2006.
That's right.
Drafted 2004. That's right. It's like,
2004,
wow.
Yeah. I had more hair.
You looking better, yeah?
Yeah.
I look better now, except like 2006, I think. 2004.
Easy.
No, it's not easy.
Don't.
Better shape, looking better.
You didn't like the way you looked? How old were you when you drafted? 18?
Yeah, 18. Old guys 18, yeah.
So you were young.
Yeah, but not look great. Yeah, I remember like it's nice draft, but I remember like, you know, I knew like probably I second overall, but it's still like when like Evgeni go first and like I'm sit like in like with my family, friends, and I like, oh, why it's not, if not, I'm going second, you know? I'm so nervous, I surprised. I like, maybe feel like 99% like I select second one, but it's still like when like Ovechkin gone, and like they have like 5 minutes between like teams change on stage, and like my like arms wet, like I'm sit like, oh, if I'm not second, like, was like who your team, you know, like I'm so nervous, I don't know why, like, you know.
What was more nervous for you, waiting to see when you get picked or game 7 of the Stanley Cup Finals against Detroit?
It's different nervous, you know.
Well,
of course game 7 is like, but when you play you're not nervous, like you nervous before game, you know. All like when you're nervous is only night before, like you can't sleep, you know.
Yeah,
because you think too much, like, you know, we lost year before,
yeah,
and you start thinking, oh, what's if we lost this year, you know? It's worst feeling ever, like when you lost like in final, you know, and like you have another chance in game 7. We play in Detroit, good team, you know, like we understand it's 50-50, but it's still like you can't sleep, but when you step on ice you're like, you're fine, you're like, you know, it's only when you sit on bench again, 1 minute left, and you watch like how your teammates play.
Yeah.
Empty net. This is nervous time, but when you like have puck, you play power play, you not think about like, you know, oh, I have mistakes, but you just play, you know.
Coming up next on Inside Penguins Hockey, presented by UPMC, the official healthcare provider of the Pittsburgh Penguins. I asked Geno about his play this season, fatherhood, and his son's infatuation with hockey. That's next on Inside Penguins Hockey. Return.
Are you happy with the season you're having now? I mean, you talked about training so hard this offseason and getting into the shape that you thought you could be. You know, you said you're older now, 33. You like the way you're playing? Still a lot to go with the season, but...
You know, I'm never happy to like my game. I always think like I can better, you know. Like if I like have 100 points, I always think I should have like 120, you know. But I think it's like good to yourself be better like every day, every game. But if you say like overall, like I think it's like good season so far. Like great shape, you know. I feel like so much confidence, you know. And like I changed stick this year, I changed my skates, you know, and I feel so much better, you know. And like again, like team play unbelievable, you like all good, like my family good, like I'm like have chance to win one more maybe cup, you know, here, like we have great team this year and like playoff soon. And, like,
being a father, is it easier for you to have, let's say you have a tough game, maybe not you personally, but the team loses.
Come home,
and, you know, you're not happy. Is it easier for you to kind of...
Easy to forget when you start with, you play a kid, you easy to forget bad game, yeah, for sure.
Because you come home and he's smiling, or you take him...
100% when he, like, come to give you a hug, you know, it's, like, always, like, best feeling ever. And it doesn't matter what's going on, like, night before, like, you wake up and your son, like, jump to your bed, what I had. At like 8 a.m. I don't like that, but it's still a nice feeling, you know.
Sure.
And it, of course, like it's easy, like change your mind right away, like you're like, okay, like game it's over now, it's like my family here, you know, like
when you were younger, you couldn't do that, right?
Oh, no.
Always game, 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 game.
And yeah, it was like when you, like, what's like, called like experience, like it's like when you're younger, you think too much, like, you know, it's like game seven, you know, like you're not asleep. But when you're older, like you understand, like, oh, you can't change anything. Go to bed, sleep, and like be ready to game, you know? This is mean experience, like, and I think if like tomorrow game seven, I go bed tonight and I'm sleep, like, unbelievable, like.
Really?
Oh, for sure.
Do you still miss your mom's cooking? The borscht and everything else that you can have back home?
Yeah, of course.
When she comes here with your father, does she cook up a lot of home meals? Like,
she not understand, like, I'm eat healthy right now, you know? She still give me like pierogies, like, you know, lots of breads, you know, like, I tell her like, easy, mom. But soup, it's nice, like, still like borscht is not like
best. That's not heavy?
Yeah, not really.
What about after hockey? Have you thought about that? Not that you're ready to quit now, I know you're not.
Yeah, but.
But more?
No, I just use pork.
Have you thought about what you want to do?
I take your job. Or we work together, what do you want?
I like to work with you, that would be nice. But
you will be my teacher or what?
Well, you see Max Talbot now, he's doing TV.
How is he did
good.
Last night?
Yeah? Very good. Well, he was doing the announcing in, you know, French language night.
Yeah.
That's easy, but now he's doing TV in
he's
Montreal.
He's loving it, yeah.
Oh, him and Bernard.
I knew Bruno when he's playing here, I knew when he's retired, I knew he'd like work on TV for sure.
He's funny, good personality.
Yeah, and he loves like camera and I want him.
Oh, yeah. Would you want to do TV? Really?
I'm joking, Potash. No, I'm rest.
Obviously, you want to play with hockey with your son, so you can't fix your body completely because you're going to take him on the ice, right? Like you do now.
Yeah, I won't take his like practice today, but he's a little bit sick like a couple days. And I'm not taking it today. But he's coming to game tomorrow for sure. He loves hockey, you know. I'm happy because we play like every day. Like he's like cold stick like forever. He like I sent you a picture, like he probably have like 25, 30 bucks at home. Real bucks.
Does he play in the house?
Any team. Yeah, he loves like play outside in my house. He have like room, he play. But he like just like have, you know, he like looking, you know, touring. It's so funny, and like probably have like 50 balls, you know.
Really?
Yeah, because he's like different size, you know. He play like small one, tomorrow he's one bigger one, you know, next one he's well, like he play like basketball, you know, soccer. He loves balls too, you know.
Do you want him to be a hockey player or does it not
I can't play? Say yes or no. I only can say why not, you know, like if he loves hockey and like we like probably like I can help him, you know, like be a hockey like player, you know. I'm like, I knew everything about hockey, you know. Of course, I'm try to give him like all my best, you know, and like if he start playing hockey and he loves, I say yes, of course.
Coming up next on Inside Penguins Hockey, presented by UPMC. Geno and I discuss whether or not he's taken on more of a mentoring role, as well as the youth movement in the NHL. That's next when IPH returns.
Inside Penguins Hockey is presented by UPMC, the official healthcare provider of the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Does he like living in America? You like living here during the season?
I think he not understand much like where he is living, you know, but he love water, he love ocean. Like, I think he love like living in Miami right now because like he can swim like all day, you know.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, he love like pool and like ocean. But then still here, like if you say like him like, oh, let's go to game, he's so excited, you know. He understand like. Yesterday I say against who we play, he said Montreal, you know, he knows teams.
He knows.
And, yeah. He have book like in every logo, like every team.
Yeah.
And I tried like this is Penguins, this is Montreal, and show him. he's remember, you know. And I give him like puck two, like it's like Penguins against Montreal, and he knows logos too, you know. Not every team, but probably like 5-6 like logos he knew.
Does he speak
Russian?
Do you want him to speak English as well? Do you try to get him to speak both languages?
Or? Oh yeah, for sure. It's like what we want, like, because he go like preschool here, like in morning, like,
yeah.
And like here, like it's, we have Russian preschool, like it's like private, like 5-6 kids, like in big house, and all Russians.
Oh.
Yeah, here in Pittsburgh, and when we stay in Miami, he go to American school, like, but it's like a little bit more people, like it's like really like class, you know, like 10 like kids. And I see a little bit tough for him when he's gone. He's like not understand what they talk, and he always like ask what they want, you know. But now he understand a little bit more. He more exciting, you know. But it's still like he's really like Russian right now. But
okay, so speaking of kids, but different kind of kids. Now that you're a little older, been playing for 15 years, when you see some of the younger Penguins that come in, do you feel your experience, your talent, that you can help them in a way that maybe Sergei Gonchar helped you when you were, you know, a rookie? Do you like playing almost like as if you're a father to some of the younger kids, in the sense that, you know, you can help them on the ice with the way they play? And I mean, you're not a coach, I get that. But you've had, you know, years of experience.
Yeah, I'm trying to help, but I think I'm not doing much, you know. I'm still like a little bit quiet. I'm still like a little bit like confused sometimes, you know, like, because I feel I'm still young, you know.
Yeah.
You know, and when like, okay, Marina come like and play first year, I feel I'm same age, you know. I'm like, I play 25 minutes every game. I feel I'm like not coaches, like not father. I still think I'm like same age like Marina.
You think you're still
18 years old
right now?
Yeah,
that's good. But you think like that in life anyway, right?
But I think I need like take more power for myself and like help like a little bit better for sure.
It's still a kind of a learning process for you.
Yeah, for sure. It's not easy, you know, but now you see like young guys, they like superstar, you know, like they come to league, score 100 points. What you can say to McDavid, like he's 20 years old, but he scored like, what do you say to Marina? He's like maybe best player like in Rocky, like
rookie, I mean,
yeah, Rocky defense, but Colorado have one guy, Makar, he's good too, but it's still like, what you can say to him? Like he's like unbelievable player. He's like, he's doing everything, you know?
You don't think McDavid can learn something from you?
Oh no, I'm learning to him.
You're learning from him?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
Coming up next on Inside Penguins Hockey, presented by UPMC. What's left for Evgeni Malkin to do in the National Hockey League? Plus, Geno gives me some tips on interviewing. That's next when Inside Penguins Hockey returns.
Inside Penguins Hockey is presented by UPMC, the official healthcare provider of the Pittsburgh Penguins.
You've done a lot in the NHL. Championships, scoring title, MVP. What else do you want to do?
I only can do it and play hockey, that's it. And I want, like, when you like play all your life like hockey, your mentality like win, you know. I won't win every game, I won't win cup, I won't win like maybe one more close my trophy, you know, one more like MVP, you know.
So winning another Stanley Cup would be number one?
Yeah, you asked me this question, like what about like Sid? He win like everything when he's like 20, like what, 2 years old?
A lot, yeah.
Yeah, he's like win cups, like he win like MVP, win everything. Why he's still playing? Because he
loves the game.
Yeah, what are you talking about? We love the game. When you win like trophies, you hungry, you win more. Like, it's like you, we're all human. Like, it's like what we like, you play hockey like 25 years and it's only like your job, like, and of course you want like win every day, you know. Win is most like best feeling ever when you win, you know.
Okay, so because you say that, now understand my job. You go out tomorrow, you score.
You win nothing.
No. Huh? You score a hat trick, I have to go talk to you, right? Huh? Big game.
You do a lot. Big for you?
Big for me to get the interview.
Of course, yeah.
Okay, so the next game, you do it again, I have to go back to you again because I'm hungry for the next big interview. You're hungry to win more championships. I had to get the next big story.
It's only problem, I'm not scored two hat tricks.
You still have time. You still have time. You could. You always give me a hard time.
Potash,
why do you want to talk to me? No.
You know what's funny? Because...
Now you know why. Because I have to keep going for the next one. Just like you want the next trophy.
You know what's funny for me? When you want to talk to me after game? Because it's most questions are similar, you know? Oh, Gino, how's your game? Like, you not talk to, like, when we lost. Like, you only talk when we win. And when we win, okay, we play good.
Yeah.
You score.
Okay.
Like, oh, thank you, fans. You know? That's it. What's like I can say to new for you, like, Potash, we win tonight, I'm score because we eat sushi. It's only thing, hey, if I score tomorrow, yeah, this is new.
We'll do it again.
Yeah.
Here's a big question. Last big question. This is important.
For you or for me?
Both. When you score your 500th goal, we'll be going for dinner.
It's not soon.
What do you mean? It's not that
maybe
far.
Maybe you not work anymore here.
I'm not going anywhere.
I'm playing here for sure, but maybe you not?
You play here for sure, I'll still be here for sure.
500 is what, like 90 more?
Steak. Pizza.
What city? Pittsburgh or like, we need to find city.
To go have dinner for?
Something new city, I don't know, like.
Okay.
Seattle. I've never been.
Oh, you love Seattle. It's like Vancouver. Beautiful. Beautiful city.
I've never been, you know. Like,
you like when, it.
Next year, Tim?
I think the year after.
And maybe year after I'm scoring 500 goals?
You want to...
And you find me like good restaurant in Seattle?
You know what they have in Seattle that you like? Seafood. Sushi. Very good.
Okay, you find good restaurant in Seattle?
I got this on tape, so you can't back out.
We can't cut.
No, I can't cut the truth. I cut the bad stuff out. I leave the good stuff in. Hey.
I tell you the truth. Seattle, 500 goals, good restaurant.
Okay. All right.
Two cities, Seattle, your choice, Seattle or Vegas.
Well, as you saw, our time together was more than just good sushi. It really was good conversation, which is why I look forward to the next opportunity when he gets to goal number 500. Hey, let's be honest. Not that far away. That's going to do it for this very special edition of Inside Penguins Hockey, presented by UPMC, the official healthcare provider of the Pittsburgh Penguins. I'm Dan Potash. We'll see you next month.